Welcome back to my channel. My name is Alejandra. I am a language coach and I help people to learn languages successfully and effectively as they enjoy the process of learning a language. So if you're new here, welcome, and I'm so happy that you're here. Last week, we talked about the mistakes that Spanish speakers make when they try to speak English. It got me thinking, there's just something else that I want to convey about pronunciation. So I decided to compile the top 5 rules that I believe are super important for people who want to improve their English pronunciation. And these rules have definitely helped me a lot along, you know, the course of my life to improve my English pronunciation, and I really hope that they can also be very useful for you and just get your results. So without further ado, let's dive in. So the first rule that I want to talk about has to do with learning to disassociate letters from sounds. And I understand that this can be a little bit difficult in Spanish because we're very used to understanding this letter has this specific sound and that's about it. However, in English, that's not the case. In English, several sounds can be attached to different letters. For example, the letter A can be pronounced as A, such as table, or it can also be pronounced as a, such as apple. That's one example of one specific letter having multiple sounds. You can also have the same sound or similar sounds with different letters. For example, cup. So even though it has a U, it's actually pronounced with an a sound. It's not an a, but it's an a. So it's cup or luck. So it's a similar A sound, but it's attached to a different letter. As you see, you have to learn to disassociate different sounds to specific letters. And once you understand this, this is gonna be incredibly helpful for you to improve your pronunciation, because if you don't do this, your mind is not gonna be open to the idea that, hey, this letter can actually be pronounced in a different way. And I was not expecting this. So please learn to do this. And it just takes a little bit of practice. But once you just accept in your mind and in your heart that, hey, sadly, in English, this is not the way that it is in Spanish, then you're far better off. Take that into account. Rule number 2, learn to master the schwa sound. And last week, we talked a little bit about this sound, but it's all over the English language. Because it doesn't exist in Spanish, it can be a little hard for us to understand how it works. But once you understand it, and once you try to find it in the different words and sentences, then it's just going to be so much easier for you to be able to improve your pronunciation. For this particular sound, I actually talked about it last week. You have to really listen to native speakers speak, because that's when you're going to be able to you know, pick up where the sound is actually normally used. If you master the schwa sound, you are going to be a lot, you know, better in your pronunciation. One thing that I have to say about this sound, so you can understand it better, is that it's almost a lazy sound. It's like an ugh. I gave this example as well in the last video, but I want a cup of coffee. I want a cup. You don't even pronounce it. It's just like an ugh. So if you think about it as a very relaxed and lazy sound, and you are paying attention constantly, you know, when people speak, then you're going to be able to pick up where people usually use it. So rule number 3 that I think it's incredibly important is pay attention to your mouth. Pay attention to how your mouth moves in order to talk or to speak, right? So the way that I like to think about it is that I need to know where I come from. So that is, I need to understand how my mouth moves in Spanish so that whenever I try to speak English, I understand where I come from. You should pay attention to your mouth when you speak Spanish. And then you have to pay attention to native speakers' mouths to see how they do it. And then you say, oh, they do it this way, and I'm doing it wrong because I'm trying to do it with my Spanish, you know, movements and articulators. For example, in Spanish, the letter D is pronounced as V. So I have to stick my tongue out a little bit and say V. right? So finger would be dedo. My tongue is out. However, in English, this the same, you know, letter sound is D, D. So my tongue is actually inside. In order to improve my pronunciation, I have to think, okay, so if in Spanish I usually say de, in English I have to say D or D, D. Okay, rule number four. This one can seem a little bit contradictory to the first one, but this one is actually learn to find sound patterns in words that are spelled similarly. For example, second person reason. Those three words end with O-N, and all of those words are also stressed in their first syllable from left to right. As I mentioned, the schwa sound, it's a lazy sound, and it's also unstressed, which means that we can assume that the vowel O in these three letters, in these three words, excuse me, is pronounced as a schwa. So second person reason. So it's not an O, it's a schwa. So that is a pattern that you can possibly follow with most of the words that end with O, N, and that don't have their first, their last syllable stressed. It happens with other types of words such as organization or comprehension. All of those words that end in ation somehow, if you think about it, they're not stressed in their last syllable, which means that even though you see a different spelling, so I-O-N, the pronunciation is also a schwa. It's organization, comprehension, pronunciation. So look for patterns that can help you to identify possible sound patterns in similar words or words that are spelled similarly. And last but not least, rule number five, use the International Phonetic Alphabet. This is one of the most useful resources that I have ever used to improve my pronunciation. Why? Because it shows you the sounds like physically. So you can see how sounds are pronounced. And as a Spanish speaker, I know that this is incredibly helpful because we're very used to understanding sounds attached to letters. Even though you won't see letters, you'll see sounds, you'll be able to see them more clearly and you'll be able to understand them and you'll be able to, you know, somehow incorporate them into your pronunciation. So use this alphabet. I am going to give you guys a resource down below in the description, and it's a website where you can go and transcribe words into phonetic transcription. And this is going to be really helpful for you guys if you want to understand how certain words are pronounced. So you can also see the phonetic transcription, so you can understand how things work in terms of pronunciation. I hope that this resource will be helpful for you guys. Just to recap, the five rules are, the first is to learn to disassociate letters from sounds. The second one is to master the schwa sound. The third one is to pay attention to your mouth and native speakers' mouths as well. Rule number four is to try to look for sound patterns in words that are spelled similarly. And rule number five is to use the International Phonetic Alphabet. Okay guys, this is it for today's video. I hope you have enjoyed it. Remember that I post videos every single Friday about language learning strategies, mindset, and success. And please subscribe down below if you haven't already. Like this video if you have. Please feel free to share with your family and friends or people who are interested in improving their pronunciation. And I hope you have a fantastic rest of your weekend, and I cannot wait to see you next time. Bye!